in accounting and finance. Now, answer this question. What is the need for ethics in accounting and finance? If there is a purchase manager, continue, I have got no botheration, I will extend accordingly. Now, where there is a purchase manager, if he defrauds someone, if he makes a default, who is going to get affected? Creditor is going to get affected. Sales manager is making a default, who is going to get affected? Debtor. The customer. HR manager is going to make a default, defraud, who is going to get affected? Employee. A finance manager is making a defraud, who is going to get affected? Company, creditors, debtors, government, investors, come on everyone. But we hold such a position that whereas any other department person is going to make any defraud, only the respective parties are going to get affected. But where a finance manager is making a defraud, what happens? All the stakeholders, all the persons who are associated with the company, they get affected. Now listen, what are all the reasons for unethical behavior? Listen, short-sightedness. What is this short-sightedness? Listen, let us say for example, Mr. Prasanna Venkatesh is my sales manager. Today is 31st of August. I tell to Prasanna Venkatesh, Prasanna Venkatesh, for August month, your sales must be 200 lakhs. Abdin, I tell to Prasanna Venkatesh. Actually, how much sales he has done now? He has done a sales of only 150 lakhs. I want him to do 200 lakhs. Now, Prasanna Venkatesh is thinking something. What he is doing? The persons who have booked order for the next month, all those orders, he transfer it as order for this particular month. Thereby what happens? This month's target is achieved. For next month, what he will do? He will try to procure fresh orders. If that is not possible, now what he will do? The subsequent month's order, he will forge those dates and he will make it as this month's order. Thereby, over a period of time, what happens? The respective months suffer because it has contributed not for its profit, it has contributed for the preceding year's profit or the preceding month's profit. Yes or not?
Yes, sir.
If this happens on a small scale basis like this, look at the large scale basis. See, individuals, firms and all always have an object of reducing the tax liability. But companies always have an object of increasing the profit, increasing the tax liability, because more and more profit you make, the share value will increase, people will call you as a good company, reputed company, responsible, right? Yes. Always my object is to what? To keep on increasing the profit. How do I go about increasing the profit? Number one, I will make genuine sales. If that is not possible, the next year sales I will book it in this year. I will book some forged sales, I will book some dummy sales. I will not account all the expenses this year, some expenses of this year, I will intentionally postpone it for the next year. I will not capitalize some assets this year, though I have started using the assets, as a result of which depreciation impact will not be there in my profit and loss account. These are all some of the mechanisms how you can play with this financial numbers. Everybody? But now what happens? I have already told you a story, if you remember. I told you there was an audit where I carried.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And one of the employees, he looted somewhere around 1.5 crores by playing with the debtors. Through this concept called as steaming and lading. Whatever sales he made to a particular debtor, whatever receipt he collected from a particular debtor, he will post it in another account and then he will go and collect money from that particular debtor. Suppose A is there, B is there. B's receipt, he will post it in A's account, and he will go and collect, the cashier will go and collect the cash from A, and the cashier will enjoy that cash. Tomorrow when he is making sales to C, whatever receipt he is getting from C, he will book it in B's account. From D, it will be booked in C's account. Like this he was playing. So short-sightedness, what is the reason for all these things? This year I want to make a profit, this year I want to make a profit, this year I want to make a profit. Short-sightedness. Next, business cycle. You might have read, every company for that matter must necessarily pass through certain business cycles. Say for example, boom, recession, depression, recovery, all these cycles is natural for every company. What Satyam did? Even in the years when all the other companies were making losses, somehow Satyam managed to prove, at least on records, that it was making a profit. How it got all the profits? Because of all the fudged numbers or the forged numbers, it got all these things. Apo, where I am not moving in line with the business cycle, I want to disprove the business cycle, all the other chemical, cement industry is making a loss, still I want to prove that I am making a profit. What I will do? I will manipulate my numbers and then I will report some wrong numbers. So this is another reason. If I want to go against the business cycle, this is another thing. Next, small ethical lapses are being ignored. Anything which is big doesn't start big. It starts small, small, it becomes culprit. I cannot straight away steal 5 crore rupees today. If I want to start to cheat 5 crore rupees, first initially you would have stolen some 5 rupees, then you would have stolen some 500 rupees, then I might have stolen some 5000 rupees. Gradually only things will take place, yes or not? So this mistake is small. If you leave a mistake, then there is a probability that the small mistake might tomorrow turn out to be a big mistake. So all the small ethical lapses which are being ignored are all the reasons for unethical behavior in this accounting and finance. Then this I will not discuss with you. You all know, as an accountant, what are all the basic principles you should follow? Integrity, objectivity, confidentiality, professional behavior, then this professional competence and due care. The line you would have read in your accounting auditing standards, which you call it as standards on auditing. This is the first standard, base standard. Next, creating ethical environment. In my workplace, how do I go about creating an ethical environment? Problem is this. Listen. I am a clerk. I am a clerk. My boss is telling, see, sir, I am saying, sir, we have to capitalize this asset. If we capitalize this asset, the depreciation impact will be 120 crores. So we need to capitalize the asset. My boss is saying, no, this year you don't capitalize, next year you capitalize. Sir, asset was already used this year, sir, so this year only I should capitalize, sir. I am telling this to my boss. My boss is saying, no, you capitalize it next year. Now tell me whether this is right or this is wrong. This is wrong, this is unethical, yes or not? Now I am placed with a very peculiar scenario. Number one, I should obey my boss. Number two, I should also obey my ethics. My ethics say that what I am going to do is wrong. But my boss is saying you do this, thereby what I am doing is right. But now I am placed with a confusion. I have an ethical dilemma. I have a dilemma whether I should go about this, I should do this, or I should not do this. See, if my colleague is doing any mistake, then I can go and complain to my boss. But when my boss himself is doing a mistake, where will I go and complain? I get all company labada. Yo. Huh? Boss wife. Boss wife. See, mole. Listen. உன் பாஸ் எல்லாம் ரொம்ப கேர்ஃபுல்லா இருக்கணும்டா. பாஸ் வைஃப் கூட உனக்கு என்னடா லிங்க்? நான் லிசன் 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 சி. அப்போ ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ், திஸ் இஸ் கம்ப்ளீட்லி அன்ஃபேர். Now listen, listen, listen. Many mistakes are being done by the employees because they do not know that it is a mistake. Say for example, 10 o'clock office, you are coming by 10:15, it's a mistake. Say for example, this evening the report must be forwarded, you are not forwarding the report this evening, it's a mistake. Say for example, you should not make any personal calls using the office line, this is a mistake. Now what happens, many employees, they are not aware that this is a mistake. Appa have to create an ethical environment. First educate the employee, create some induction program, create some training program, ensuring the employees are aware of their legal and ethical responsibilities. Train the employees, give some education to the employees, what is right, what is wrong, what is good, what is bad. Respond everyone. Next, if you were in my position, boss itself is forcing me to do something wrong, what will you do in this position? You will do or you will not do? Do, not do. Now what happens in this scenario, they should provide a proper communication channel between the management and the employee. Now I should have some person whom I can go and speak. Maybe he can be an ombudsman or he can be any other person in the organization which the organization has declared as a grievance redressal person or the complaint making person. So the organization should provide a proper communication channel between the management and the employees. Now listen, what happened? We call this as whistleblowing. What is this? Come on. What is this whistleblowing? So nobody is going to see you. Why do you do all these things? So what is this whistleblowing? See, I'll tell you what happened. There was a company where one young lady, some 20, 21 years old young lady who knew nothing in accounts, she joined in that company. And there were some seniors who educated her on accounts, who taught her all the nuances of accounts, and now she became an expert in accounts. So the seniors, they became super seniors and she became the senior. Now when she was perusing the financial record, she found out that the super seniors were engaged in a fraud. Now there is a problem for her. Array, if you see the personal aspect of me, today I am in this organization only because of these persons. How can I go about complaining these persons? How can I disclose to the outside world that these persons are not proper? But if you see the other aspect, now what these people are doing are wrong. Though they are my super seniors, though they taught me everything, now what they are doing is wrong. What should I do this? If I should complain, I should go and complain only to this super seniors who are all the root cause for the mistake. So what she did? She went and she informed to the managing director. She went and she informed to the managing director. This is what we call as whistleblowing. This is what we call as a whistleblowing. So now, what is that we are saying? You should ensure fair treatment to the whistleblowers. You should not insult the whistleblowers. Come on, yeah. What happened? In this company Enron, which was a leading company, which was a very good company in US, in this company Enron, a lady, a normal accountant, she came to the managing director and she told that there are some problems in the accounts of the company. The managers, the senior managers, they are involving in some fraud. The financial figures, they are not proper figures, they are not correct numbers, they are involving in fraud. She came and reported to the managing director. Managing director ignored because she is a normal accountant. Few days later, it was found out that the company has become insolvent and the company went into winding up. Later, when it was found out what is the reason for all these things, one of the reasons was that the managing director did not take a proper care when the information was brought to his knowledge. So you should always ensure, make sure that you give a fair treatment to the whistleblowers. You should not do this to the whistleblowers. So you should give a fair treatment to the whistleblowers. Are you all following? Everyone? What are all the threats which are faced by finance and accounts professionals? What are all the threats which are faced by finance and accounts professionals? We are going to discuss some 4 to 5 threats. Number one, self-interest rate. Without reading this, don't read that. Tell me, what is meant by self-interest rate? I am having 10 clients. My total income is 10 lakh and 10,000. One client is giving me 10 lakh. Balance 9 clients put together, they are giving me 10,000. Now, which client is more important to me?
All the clients.
All the clients are that client giving 10 lakh rupees. The client giving 10 lakh rupees is more important to me, yes or not?
Yes,
tomorrow, if that client is engaging in some unlawful activities, as an auditor, I should report to this, correct or not?
Yes,
will I report to that?
No.
Because this time I report that, what will happen? Next time, will I be reappointed as an auditor? No. Which means my major income generating source will come to when? Yeah. This is what threat? Though I know that there is a problem, still I keep quiet. Because what type of threat? This is a self-interest threat. Because my interest is affected. Or for example, they say, sir, what is this 10 lakh, sir? This time you do audit, you sign this financial statement. Next time you come and join our company as an employee, we will pay you 25 lakhs per annum. We will pay you 25 lakhs per annum. So now, this year, the financial statement which I am going to sign is an absolute ridiculous financial statement. I should throw my conscience completely if I want to sign this financial statement. There is no nexus between the financial position and the financial statement. But now what happens? If I am going to sign this financial statement, next year I will be employed in 2.5 times income more than what I am earning now. 25 lakhs per annum I am going to get. If I am not going to sign this, number one, I am going to lose this audit, but I am ethically proper. Now tell me, which one I will choose? Depends upon the people. So this is next thing. Where there is a prospective employment with the particular client, this is again self-interest threat. Next. There is a partnership firm. This partnership firm is engaged in textile business. I am the auditor of that partnership firm. With the same person, a person who is a partner here, I am a partner for some other business. Say for example, some other business, plastics manufacturing business, I am a partner with him for some other business. Now what happens? If I say the textile firm financial statements I will not sign because all these financial statements are not proper, I will not only lose this audit, I will lose the partnership in this plastics manufacturing division also. So all these things are nothing but self-interest threat. My interest is going to get affected now. I can do anything and everything. This is the general mindset of human being. Correct or not?
Yes, sir.
Sorry, what are all these self-interest threat? A financial interest in a client or jointly holding a financial interest with a client. Undue dependence on total fees from a client. Having close business relationship. Concern about possibility of losing a client. Potential employment with a client. If I am an employee, I am not an auditor. If I am an employee, what are all the problems which I face? Obviously, I will lose my employment. My boss says, come on, fudge the financial statements. Now I say, no, I will not fudge the financial statements. Next time, will I be in the company?
No.
they will throw me out of the company. So self-interest threat. As an employee also, I have got some self-interest threat. Financial interest, loan guarantees, etc. Say for example, I am purchasing a house for which I have got a housing loan of 40 lakhs from the company. The boss is saying you fudge the financial statements. I say I cannot fudge the financial statements. Now he says, okay, leave the company, immediately pay that 40 lakhs and you move away from the company. Will I be in an immediate position to pay 40 lakhs? No. Only option available is to sell the house. Will I be inclined to sell the house? No. So thereby what I will do now, whether I like it or not, I will succumb to the needs of my boss. Apo, all these things, they are self-interest threat. Next, self-review threat. Self-review threat. Say for example, Mr. Topi, he is going and doing audit for the first 6 months of MT Educare Limited. Listen, children.
Yes, sir.
He is going and doing the audit for the first 6 months of MT Educare Limited. And he is giving a clean report. For this first 6 months, there is no problem. He is giving a clean report. Then he is coming for the next 6 months audit. When he is coming for the next 6 months audit, now only he is realizing there is a problem in the first 6 months. Now will he go and tell to MT Educare? No, there is a problem in the first 6 months. At that point of time, I forgot to tell you. Will he tell or he will not tell? Because if he is going to tell this now his personal image is going to get affected. Up, what type of threat is this? Self-review threat. Where I am going to review my own work, then you call it as a self-review threat. Next. I am starting a company. I am a layman. I am starting a company on a large scale basis. So I am engaging Mr. Samosa Satya, saying that you design the financial controls for me. Who is the authorizing persons? Pa valayara randa endu vella poite irunga pa. Now you design the financial controls of my company, I am saying. So what happened? Satya is also designing the financial controls of my company. All the internal controls, I do it as per the specifications of Satya. I appoint Satya himself as an auditor. Satya is having two intelligent articled assistants. They are coming to Satya with a 20-page report stating what are all the problems in the internal control system. Sir, I don't know which idiot has framed this internal control system, sir. For 20 pages, we have drafted a report on the problems of internal control system. Satya is saying, he cannot show any reaction because he knows that he is that. Come on, everywhere. Now, can he come and tell me, sir, in your internal control system, there is a problem. You are the person responsible for that. Will he come and tell me this now? No. Come on, yeah.
Yes, sir.
Now, what is this? This is a self-review threat. Reviewing one's own work is what we call as a self-review threat. Next. Satya is an employee of my company. He is the CFO of my company. He only carried all the transactions in my company. Every entry, no single entry will pass without Satya's permission. In the month of January, Satya, he resigned from my company. And then he went and joined an audit firm. Which audit firm? The audit firm which is doing the audit of my company. And he becomes the senior partner there. He is coming and doing the audit. And he is saying, sir, from April to January, accounts are very bad, sir. I ask him, who maintained the accounts, sir? You only maintained the accounts. No, sir. That is different. This is different. Now, will he tell all these problems? No. About where an employee, he becomes a partner of an audit firm or he becomes an audit manager of an audit firm, will he disclose his own problems? What are all the mistakes he did? Will he disclose or he will not disclose? No. This is called as self-review threat. The discovery of a significant error during a re-evaluation of the work of the finance and accounting professional. As I told you, first 6 months audit over, next 6 months audit, I find a problem in the first 6 months. Reporting on the operation of financial systems after being involved in their design or implementation, member of the assurance team, being or having recently been a director or officer of the client, accounting employee subsequently appointed as a member of the internal audit department. These are all the self-review trait. Reviewing my own work is called as a self-review trait. Advocacy threat. Advocacy threat. I am promoting my client. This is called as an advocacy threat. Listen. Say for example, I am an auditor. I am auditing the books of accounts of ABC Limited, which is a listed public company. Now you are all coming and asking me, sir, suggest some good company in which we can investment, sir, in which we can make investment, whose shares we can purchase. I recommend you. You all purchase the shares of ABC Limited. It's a very good company. You cannot find any mistakes in the company. Please invest in the shares of ABC Limited. I am saying you all. So I have advocated, I have promoted for ABC Limited, yes or not? That year financial statement, profit is 70 crores. I say, no, no, this should not be a profit of 70 crores. There should be a loss of 120 crores. I give an adverse audit report. I give an adverse audit report. You know four types of audit reports, sir. I give an adverse audit report. This audit report, this accounts are ridiculous. I give an adverse audit report. Will my heart accept to give an adverse audit report? Because I have already promoted the company. Respond, children.
Yes, sir.
This is what we call as an advocacy threat. Promoting shares in a listed entity when that entity is a consultancy or a financial statement audit client. Acting as an advocate on behalf of an assurance client in litigation or disputes with third parties. For example, multidisciplinary firms can be there. What is meant by multidisciplinary firms? Same firm, they will have auditor, they will have company secretary, they will have cost accountants, they will have lawyers. You call this as a multidisciplinary firm. So every services are offered under one roof. Now what happens? I am a partner in that firm and I give an adverse report in the audit report. On the basis of this audit report, the matter goes to the court. Some shareholders file a suit in the court of law. And I am also a lawyer. So I am going and presenting before the court in favor of the company. Saying that no, what the company did is correct. Abdin, I am going and acting in favor of the company. Now what happens? There is an advocacy threat. I have given an adverse report for the same issues. I am going and arguing in favor of the company. This is what we call as an advocacy threat. Familiarity threat. What is this threat? Familiar. Now listen. What is this familiarity threat? You know my friend SS?
Yes,
now what happens? Mr. SS, he is the managing director of a company. I am the auditor of that company. Now what will happen? I tell to SS, hey SS, what is this? 20 crore rupees you have not accounted this time. SS says, hey, this one time, no, leave here. I am close friend of you, no. What do I do? Okay, yeah. This time you leave. Next time onwards you should be proper. Why do I accept this? Because of our friendship. Because I know him, I do this. Yes or not? Same problem arises when you have the same client over a period of time. Say for example, there are some auditor and client who have got 60 years relationship, 65 years relationship. Since the birth of the company, they will be the auditor. But what will happen? The managing director of the company and the auditor, they will be very, very close. Come on, everyone. This is what we call as a familiarity threat. Say, for example, MFJ, he goes and joins a company. Come on, everyone. Now, I go and find some problems in that company. I am the auditor of the company. I go and find some problem with the company. I am telling this to MFJ, sir. Sir, what is this? Says, Mahesh, this time you leave. No, please. So what I will do? I will not question this. So what type of threat is this? You call this as a familiarity threat. Are you all following?
Yes, sir.
My wife's brother is a CFO in a particular company. My wife's brother. And I thought you are interested in other's wife. Even a manager wife. Now listen. my wife's brother, he is a CFO in a particular company of which I am the auditor. I am not at all accepting certain points which he is saying. Now, if I fight with my wife's brother at the office, all my articled assistants will praise me. Hey sir, he is a very very honest fellow, he is a very very ethical fellow. That evening will I get food at home? But now what type of threat you call this as? You call this as a familiarity threat. Respond children. So these are all the familiarity threat. All I have discussed. So there is no point reading this again. Next. Intimidation threat. At last. What is not possible by any of the above mechanisms, at last it is possible by way of intimidation. Intimidation and threatening. Sign this audit report. I am an ethical person. I will not sign the audit report. He keeps a pistol on my head and he says, sign the audit report. So what is intimidation threat? These are all the intimidation threats. Hold your breath. This is one of the news which got reported in a newspaper. Somewhere in the year 2004-05, if I am not wrong. So, a chartered accountant refused to sign the financial statements. So, the chartered accountant, they felt that such ethical persons should find a place only in the heavenly abode and not in this earth. So, thereby they sent him to the heavenly abode. Margaya. So, now, these are all the various intimidation threats. So what are all the various intimidation threats, Abdina? Number one, being threatened with dismissal or replacement, being threatened with false cases, being pressurized to reduce inappropriately the extent of work performed, all these things. Come on everyone, these are all the various threats which are faced by this finance and accounting professionals. Safeguards. What are all the safeguards you can take? Number one, why the employees are engaging in all these things? Because the employees, they don't have a knowledge as to how to react. So you conduct separate training program. If under these situations, if these things happen, this is how you should react. You conduct separate training programs for the employees. Another problem why they people engage in all these activities, because people, they don't have a knowledge of things. For example, there is a chartered accountant who is having 45 years of experience. Whatever is the recent development, all the recent development this chartered accountant might not know. So thereby what you need to compulsorily, you should force him to upgrade his knowledge, for which the institute is conducting with certain programs called as continuing professional education, what we call as CPE, continuing professional education. So these are all the various safeguards you can take with respect to preventing unethical behavior in the case of a workplace with respect to this accounts and finance.